إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا حق أنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، إخوتي في الله، فاعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. إخوتي في الله، يقول كعب بن عجرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان جالساً مع أصحابه ذات يوم، فنظروا إلى شاب ذي جلد وقوة وقد بكر يسعى، فقالوا: ويح هذا، لو كان الشباب وجلده في سبيل الله. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: لا تقولوا هذا، فإنه إن كان يسعى على نفسه ليكف عن المسألة ويغنيها عن الناس فهو في سبيل الله، وإن كان يسعى على أبوين ضعيفين أو ذرية ضعاف فهو في سبيل الله، وإن كان يسعى تفاخراً وتكاثراً فهو في سبيل الشيطان. رواه الطبراني في المعجم الكبير والصحاح الألباني. If you recall last week, we talked about the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when we mentioned that the nations will gather around us like a people may gather around feast or food. And we say, since they using us or seeing us as al-qas'a, as a food itself, and they are the akala, we are in this situation when the people, where the people are very difficult, in very difficult situation to prosper. And some of you may ask, what are the ways out? And what can we do? Therefore, listen to the interpretation of this basic hadith. This Sahabi Ka'b radiyallahu anhu is narrating very unique incident that took place between the Sahaba and the Messenger of Allah. He said the Messenger of Allah was sitting with the companions, and all of a sudden, a young man, Shab, with a lot of strength, physically strong. But he was not only physically strong, but he was very active. A man of his strength, the desire to act upon, what he, upon what he wants to do and accomplish. Very active. And not only that, he got up early in the morning to start his business or to start his job. And the Sahaba of the Messenger of Allah, they saw how he looks and how active he is, and that he's got up early to do the job. So they assume that whatever he's doing is not for the sake of Allah. And there is a lesson here. So they said, "Wayha hadha, woe to that man," as though he committed sin. He did something wrong. Woe to him. If only this strength and activeness is for the sake of Allah. Fi sabilillah. And at that time, this term fi sabilillah was used for in terms of jihad fi sabilillah. Fi sabilillah means if this man was really mujahid, giving his strength and energy for the sake of Allah in the battlefield, that would be far better than what he's doing at this moment. So the Messenger of Allah, look what he said. He said, "La taqulu hadha." Don't do this. Do not judge people because you see him doing certain things. Stop being judgmental. Don't put on the scale. Don't say he is this and that without you knowing the reality of his situation. So he said, "La taqulu hadha." You're not allowed to say this. You're not allowed to assume. You cannot assume. And then he explained to them. And he said, three different scenarios. One, in kana hadha, if this man, this individual, this particular person is getting early in the morning to take care of himself, ليكفها عن المسألة ويغنيها عن الناس, so he can be self-sufficient. He's not living with his parents. He's not relying on them. After they raised him, perhaps paid his education that he never completed, never finished, because he needed a year off to think through things. Or he needs time off because he's been going through high school and the first 2 years of university. Man, my God, he needs a break. You know, cheeseburger generation. This is what they want. So he said, if this man is doing this to take care of himself, not relying on anyone else, he is indeed fi sabilillah. He is a mujahid. He's like the man who's fighting the battlefield. Fi sabilillah. This is a personal need. And then he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or if he's taking care of his elder or old parents, he has his father, his mother, he said, ضعيفين, and they are weak. Oh, or he's taking care of ذريه, his children, offspring, ضعاف, who are weak. فهو في سبيل الله. He is doing, he is for the sake of Allah. However, he says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن كان يسعى تفاخرا وتكاثرا فهو في سبيل الشيطان. See the difference, ikhwati fi Allah. Exact the same act, same process. You get up early in the morning, you go to your school or to your work or to your business or to your job, but the intention is to take care of yourself and your parents and your family and you're those who are dependent on you. But on the other hand, if you're doing because you want the people to say, look what he has.
Look at the type of vehicle that he drives. Look at the nice house that he's living in. Look at the fence. Look at the front yard. Look how green the landscape is. Look at the flowers. Look at that little dog that's running around. Look at this. This is قال فهو في سبيل الشيطان. This is not في سبيل الله. This is في سبيل الشيطان. See, Islam will never approve, for young people to sit in the masjid or to sit in the basement of their parents playing video games, وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ شَكَرَ اللَّهُ لِسَعِيهِمْ, and then assume this is what they need to do. Islam will say no. You can't be in the masjid, not having a job, not having responsibility, neglecting your personal need and the need of your family and your community, and play a righteous God in the masjid. No. لذلك عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه في عام الرماد, the most difficult year in his life, he found young people in the masjid. Shabab, youth. So he said, what are you doing in the masjid? قالوا يا أمير المؤمنين, نسأل الله. We're sitting in the masjid of Bayt Allah, and we're asking Allah to provide. He said, really? He said, stay where you are. I'll be back. And barakallahu fihim, they thought that Umar bin Khattab, he would go to the Bayt al-Mal al-Muslimin, and he would slaughter from the animals of the sadaqah, and he would ask his servant to make fresh bread for these young people in the masjid, and he would bring some rice and he would serve them. But Umar bin Khattab, he forgot his durra, his stick at home. Say, I'll be back, just stay where you are. And he went to the house and brought the stick, and he closed the door and started lashing them. And so you're sitting in the Bayt of Allah, and you say, Allah, Allah, while you're certain that the sky will never rain gold nor silver, get out and get a job. Be active. Be someone in your community. Be a business-minded person. Be a businessman. See, subhanAllah, in our society, in Muslim society in the West, we don't need doctors. I'm extremely against the students who go for medical schools. I'm against it. Because as far as I can remember, we've been producing doctors left and right. However, not a single hospital. We all work for the kuffar. وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ, go to the Jew hospitals, and the best doctors are Muslims. Go to any medical center, the best doctors are Muslims. I don't need doctors. We need business people. One, people who are self-employed. Your own business. You leave your job for Salat al-Jum'ah, and you don't need to write a letter or request to your boss, or place nice and simple for him to give you the few hours off. No. We need people in education. We need people in media. And the fourth, we need people in marketing. These are the dire need of your community. Nothing else. A lot of young people, what are you studying? Public health. Allahu Akbar. Public health, barakallahu lak. What are you going to do with public health? I'm going to work in a hospital. See, Muslims have to be business-minded. Like that young man. He got up early in the morning to take care of his business. In Sunan Abi Dawood, a man came to the Messenger of Allah and he said, Ya Rasulullah, give me something from the wealth of the Muslims. Give me sadaqah. The man, the Messenger of Allah said, Do you have anything in your house? Anything whatsoever? He thought of Barqala Hals. Piece of sheep. قالوا نفرش بعض. He says, some of it, we put it on the floor, and the second part we cover ourselves with. And then he thought, and he said, and a container, منه نشرب, from that we drink. No microwave, no sophisticated electrical stove, no. Simple things, two things. He said, bring them to me. He brought them to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the masjid, fi sunan Abi Dawud, he raised them up. قال من يشتري هذا? Who would buy these? One of the sahaba said, I will purchase it, O Messenger of Allah, for one dirham. Messenger of Allah didn't like the offer. He repeated, من يشتري? Who would buy this? For the third time, one of the sahaba said, two, Ya Rasulullah. He said, they are yours. He said to this young man, come, take this dirham, feed your family with that dirham. The other dirham, go to the market, bring me an axe, and I will put a wooden handle on that. He brought it and he said, now go, I don't want to see you for 15 days. I don't want to see you. After 15 days, the man came back with 10 dirhams. Nice, brand new thobe. Food at home. And he said, which one is better now? Taking care of yourself or keep coming back to the people? Which one is better? Of course, be independent. See, subhanAllah, even at the time when we are in the middle of ibadah, act of worship, Allah says, no, do business. In the Hajj, لَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَحْ أَن تَبْتَغُوا فَضْلًا مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. During the month of Hajj, فَإِذَا أَفَضْتُمْ مِنْ عَرَفَاتٍ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ عِنْدَ مَشْعَرِ الْحَرَامِ. In Haram, in Mecca, while you're doing and performing Hajj, لبيك اللهم لبيك. You say, this is $5. I say, would you like to purchase it? Nothing is wrong with that. You're doing a dhikr. This is what it is. Muslims do not have day off. They don't have day off. The day of Jum'ah, what did Allah say? What did that? يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Walk into the remembrance of Allah. Go to the masjid. What should we do, Allah? فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةِ. When the salah is over, فَابْتَقُوا. Now get up. فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَقُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ. Now go back to your business. The salah is finished. Salatul Jum'ah is finished. Whether you're in Muslim country, non-Muslim country, go back to your work. Go back to your rizq. Of course, we don't mean give yourself to this dunya, but we mean balance it. رجال لا تقيم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله. Be like that people, those people. Men who business, commercial, personally would not distract them from the remembrance of Allah and they in the masajid. Time for salah, time for ibadah, be in the masjid. Think. Why would you be on the mercy of someone else? Why? يعني أسألكم بالله. Don't you have the skills? Yes, you do. Don't you have the capital? You do. Each one of us here have the capital. As long as you have your health and you have brain cells, you can be a businessman. In this state, and this simple man, I gave a khutbah in one of the masajid. In a different state other than the state that I was living, I think it was Connecticut. And I was living in Maryland that time. I came out of the masjid, and there's this young man who has a table selling cassettes. Not CDs, not DVDs, cassettes. And I came closer and I looked. And I realized the man is selling my cassette. I said, I know this brother. He said, of course you know, Sheikh. And he gave me $200. I said, what is it? He said, this is, you know, the money that we made. After Jum'ah, I said, we made $200? He said, no, Sheikh, that's your share. I said, how much do you? He said, we have made $400, but 50-50, since you have nothing to do with the business, 50-50. I said, Jazakallahu khair. $200 for Salatul Jum'ah. And then he said, Sheikh, since I've been selling your CD, your cassette anyway, can I continue selling them? I said, yes. He makes minimum $400 a week. $400 just for 1 hour. After Salatul Jum'ah, he comes out, he puts out a little table, he sells the cassettes, CDs, DVDs, whatever, and he makes $400 and he goes home. What did he use? Brain cells. He did not rely, I gotta find a job. It really bothers me when I see a young man, he said, well, we're going through a depression right now, really there's not much to do. I just want to smack those people, literally. You can create anything that you want. It is all here. Now look at the average Muslims in this masjid. For Salatul Jum'ah, the average, you have three to seven. We had at one point over 1,500 people in this masjid. One time, and it was an Eid. If we assume we have 500 people in this masjid, 500 people. And you say, subhanAllah, 500 people every Jum'ah. I would open a restaurant. I would open a deli. I would open a place where I can serve these Muslims in the neighborhood. Because all these 500 people, mainly from the neighborhood, from this area, they're not from Brampton, they're not from, you know, they're from here. Imagine per week. Per week. Out of these 500 people, each one of them spends $10. 500 times 10, how much, ya ikhwati fidla? 5,000. Times 4 is $20,000. Doing what? Just opening a little restaurant in the area. Now, all we need is to be able to unleash, the skills and trust ourselves and say, I can do business out of anything. Out of anything. From like that brother who was just selling cassettes and he made money. This is what it is. $1,200. Just $1,600, I'm sorry. Just for a little cassette. You can do likewise. أقول ما تسمعون استغفر الله لك فاستغفروا إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إخوتي في الله, if you move forward and allow your brothers who are standing outside to enter the masjid, بورك فيكم. الله سبحانه وتعالى will reward you. وإذا قيل لكم تفسحوا في المجالس فافسحوا يفسح الله لكم. إخوتي في الله, I am personally, I cannot speak on behalf of everyone, but I can speak on behalf of few people, more than one. And I can say, safely say, we are sick and tired on relying on other people. We are. And we are sick and tired of undermining the ability, and the skills, and the strength that we have. And I strongly believe, and you think maybe this is a bit, brother, mashallah, every Jum'ah we want to hear about, you know, something, but I'm telling you, as a community, we need this. Because if you study how the other community prosper and they reach where they are, it's because they were able to focus, able to think as units, not as individuals. They were able to unite under the umbrella of that which would benefit their own community. And they were able to control. They were able to control businesses, media, health, in this, they were able, politics, they were able to do all that. My nasiha to all of us is, first thing that you do is, instead of saying, I'm planning to work in this company until I retire, plan for your own business. And if you're not willing to plan for your own business, plan to be the customer of another Muslim business, or Muslim business, in everything that you do. If you want to cut your hair, if you want to trim, go and find a Muslim. Don't say, oh, I know Angelino, I know Bruno, this. No. Find a Muslim barbershop. If you're driving, make sure you only go to Muslim business. I'm not saying let us boycott everyone else. No. I'm saying everyone else is taking care of themselves. Let us take care of ourselves. And inshallah, with time we'll learn that alhamdulillah, masjid is packed. Now salat al-fajr, salat al-dhuhr, like Jum'ah. Because all of you are business people. You don't need a permission from your boss. You will come and you will pray with us. With us. Some of you, subhanAllah, salat al-dhuhr is 10 minutes. 10 minutes. Some of you are like, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. 10 whole minutes. My boss is waiting for me. But when you have your own business, subhanAllah. Wallahi, I will tell you, and I know I took more than past the time, a new Muslim, I don't know if I ever mentioned, a new Muslim that I gave him a shahada. Not to brag, but it was a lesson for me. And this new Muslim in Calgary, he earned 7 Wendy's restaurants. 25 people out of the people that worked for him were Muslims. They never told him about Salah, of course. They never told him about Islam, of course. And when he accepted Islam, and as I explained to him, you have to be here for every Salah, now you're Muslim from the first day, if you can, you have to be in Jama'ah. He took his cell phone and he started calling 25 people while I'm sitting with him. Telling them, you have no job if you don't pray in the masjid. You have no job if you don't come to Salah and pray in the masjid. Imagine you bringing 25 of your employees to the masjid. We will buy the next door church. We will pray on the parking lot because we will be thinking like that. We're all independent. So this is what we need, ya ikhwati fillah, as a ummah, to move forward. Let us work together as one unit. Allahumma azzil islam wal muslimin. Allahumma arhamna ya rahman rahimina. Allahumma arham li mawtana. واغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا اللهم أعز الإسلام يا أكرم الأكرم والمسلمين وارفعنا في العليين وأقم الصلاة يرحمني رحمكم الله